Colgate Cavalcade! More tubes of Colgate dental cream are sold than any other toothpaste. Millions all over the world have proved it safe, sensible, and economical. Why don't you, too, buy Colgate dental cream?
Breath is sweet, teeth are bright when you brush them on a night with Colgate dental cream.
Everybody, this is Eric Parrant telling you that the Colgate Crazy Gang is in a new business, Adventure Incorporated. We're prepared to take on anything and everything. No risk too great, no fee too small. So if you're in the mood for thrills, excitement, and adventure, draw up your will and join us at the office of Adventure Incorporated, because that's where you'll find tonight's Colgate Cavalcade. Yes, folks, Adventure Incorporated is now open for business. And I'd like you to meet my charming and dainty little secretary, Hal Lashwood.
Hey, Chafy
Pie. Hal, tell me, how much a week am I paying you?
£8 a week, Chafy Pie, but I want that altered.
Well, how much do you want?
£5 a week.
Well, I'm paying you £8 and you want £5. What's the idea?
It's very simple. If you forget to pay me at the end of the week, I won't lose so much.
Well, I must say, you've got brains.
Yes, of course I've got brains. I know I've got brains because I've heard them rattle.
Well, how are you getting along with your new typewriter?
Not so good, Chiefy Pie. She slapped me face this morning.
Oh, and what did you do?
Well, I waited a few minutes and then I slapped her back.
You slapped her back?
Yes, the poor thing was coughing. But I cheered her up.
You did?
Yes, I said, it's not the cough that carries you off, it's the coffin that carries you off in.
Ah, the doorbell, Hal. See what it is.
Yes, all right. For whom does the bell toll?
Excuse me. Is this the office of Adventure Incorporated?
Can't you read what's written on the door?
Well, let me see. There was a young man from...
No, not that.
Yes, young lady, what can we do for you?
My name is June Mendoza, and I've just fallen into a fortune.
Oh, that's funny. My name's Hal Lashwood, and I've just fallen into a waste paper basket.
You've fallen into a fortune, Miss Mendoza. But how does that affect us?
I'd better explain. My uncle recently died and has left me his country house, Dracula Castle, on Lake Erie, on the banks of the River Gore.
Oh, don't say those things, please. Me goose pimples are getting goose pimples.
Uncle has left all his fortune buried somewhere in the house.
Oh.
How much money is there?
Something in the neighborhood of £3 million.
What a lovely neighborhood.
And you want us to find this money, I take it?
No. You find it, and I'll take it.
£3 million, eh? Hal, I think you and I can handle this on our own without bringing Mo McCackie into it.
Of course, Chiefy Pie. Mo is definitely out of this deal.
Well, don't worry, Miss Mendoza. Hal and I alone will get the money for you. Can you give us any more information about this Dracula castle?
Only that it's haunted.
Haunted?
Yes. Haunted by a horrible, gruesome ghost.
Oh. Chiefy Pie.
Yes?
I've been thinking. Maui McCackie's a very man for this job.
Yes, well, I quite agree. You'll like Mo, Miss Mendoza. He's strong, brave, and handsome. And he always cleans his teeth with Colgate dental cream because it sweetens his breath at the same time.
Breath is sweet, teeth are bright when you brush them on a night with Colgate dental cream.
Is Mo McCackie afraid of ghosts?
Well, we won't tell him about the ghost. That'll be a secret between we three. Hal, you mustn't tell Mo. Swear?
Oh, very well, bother Tush and Fiddly-Dee.
I'd better warn you, Dracula Castle is in a very bad state of disrepair.
I can just imagine it. It's probably in a filthy state and hasn't been washed for years.
You call me Chief! Chief, can I have the afternoon off?
Mo, I'd like you to meet a new client, Miss June Mendoza.
Oh, Chief, would you like the afternoon off?
Miss Mr. McCackie, I've been hearing a lot about you.
That's a dirty lie. Look, I haven't been near the cash register since this morning.
Mo, Miss Mendoza's uncle has just died and has left her his country estate and £3 million.
How?
And we've got to get on the scent of that money.
With my brain, it's a cinch.
With your nose, it's a certainty.
Look, I'm dead. Oh, hell, Mo. Look at he's doing
to
me.
Let's break it up, you two.
Look at he's doing to me.
Hell, Mo, will you stop?
I'll smack his face. I'll smack him.
Now, look, Mo. Now, break it up, fellas. We're going to put you in charge, Mo, of this treasure hunt.
And I'm so glad, Mr. McCackie.
Call me Moe.
Very well, Moe.
Moe.
I'm glad you're in charge, because you're my ideal of virile Australian manhood.
Oh, curse my fatal boomerang!
Moe?
Yes?
How did you get to be so big and strong and muscular?
Well, I'm a physical culture expert.
Yes, more physical than culture. Yep.
Actually, Miss Mendoza, I owe my gigantic physique to my dadda. Dadda is a veritable giant of a man and a magnificent specimen of male manhood. You've never seen such a big joker. By the way, I better ring him up and tell him that I'm here, that I won't be home for a fortnight.
Come in, here's the phone.
Thank you.
Hello?
What do you think I am, a cockatoo? Hello there. Hello? Hello, botany toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot. Oh, is that your mama? Listen, mama, I want to speak to dadda. Oh, he's right there, is he? All right, I'll hang on.
Why hang on if your father's right there?
Mama is lifting him up to the telephone.
Well, before we start out on this dangerous expedition, here's a little music to cheer us up. Jack Carpenter and the Lester Sisters sing "There's No Business Like Show Business."
There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is appealing, everything the traffic will allow. Nowhere could you get that happy feeling when you were stealing that extra bow. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low, even with a turkey that you know. Oh, you may be stranded out in the cold, still you wouldn't change it for a sack of gold. Let's go on with the show.
The butcher, the baker, the grocer, the clerk are secretly unhappy men, because the butcher, the baker, the grocer and the clerk get paid for what they do, but no applause.
They'd gladly bid the dirty jobs goodbye for anything theatrical and wise.
Before the show has started, that your favorite uncle died at dawn. Top of that, your pa and ma have parted. You're broken hearted, but you go on.
There's no people like show people. They don't run out of dough. Yesterday they told you you would not go far. That night you opened and there you are. Next day on your dressing room, they've hung the star. Let's go on with the show.
And now here we are in the grounds of Dracula Castle. Hal, I've got to go away for a few minutes, but remember, on no account let Moe suspect that the castle is haunted.
Chiefy Pie, I won't breathe a word to him.
Good. Here he comes now.
Hello, Murray Powie.
Hello, Hal Pell.
Nobody knows what I know. Nobody knows what I know.
What do you know, Hal Pell?
Nothing. But you'll find out. A haunting we will go. A haunting we will go.
Don't sing those gruesome songs, our pal. Sing something nice and refined and romantic.
All right. If you were the only ghoul in the world.
You know, Al, look, I got a funny feeling about this place. I don't like the look of it.
Mary, I just have to tell you there's a curse on this house.
I know. I saw it written on the gate as we came in.
Not that kind of curse. Mary.
Yes?
Dracula Castle is haunted.
And very lovely, too. Haunted, strike me lucky. This is a nice time to tell me.
Yes, there's a ghost.
A boy or a girl?
What difference would that make?
It went to another ghost.
It's haunted by the ghost of one of Miss Mendoza's ancestors. Listen, is that the ghost knocking?
No, my knees. But I'm getting out just the same, Al.
Wait a minute, you promised Chiefy Pie you'd go into the house and find that treasure.
Our pal, wild Arabs couldn't drag me to that house.
Well, if you're afraid, I'll lend you me rabbit's foot. It's lucky.
It wasn't for the flaming rabbit.
Oh! Oh, look, on the wall of the house, a ghostly hand's writing a message.
What does it say, our pal?
It says, is yours a ghost of a smile? Take away the dull shadows and give your smile sparkling life with Colgate Dental Cream.
Oh. Breath is sweet, teeth are bright when you brush them on a night with Colgate Dental Cream.
Look, Al, let me out of here.
No, after me, I'm going.
Oh, he's gone. Look, our pal's gone. He's left me one out with the ghost.
Hello, Murray.
Miss Mendoza, thank goodness you've come. We've got to get out of here. There's a ghost.
I know there is.
You know?
Of course. Come for a walk and I'll tell you all about him.
Can't we, Mum? We can get away faster.
No, we'll walk. Come on. Wouldn't you like to lead me down the garden path?
Wouldn't I? You little beauty!
Murray, dear, you mustn't be afraid. This ghost has haunted Dracula Castle now for over 700 years.
Oh, just a bit of a kid.
Actually, the ghost is Sir George Mendoza. And more than 700 years ago, he murdered three of his wives.
Murdered three wives? Blimey, look, he'd be a sensation out at Redfern.
Murray, for my sake, you will help me find the treasure, won't
you? Strike me lucky. Look, I'm caught like a rat in a trap.
Oh, you will, won't you, Murray?
Oh, dear, look. When you ask me like that, there's only one thing I can say.
What?
No.
Murray, I'm bitterly disappointed in you. Fancy a big, strong, stalwart man like you being afraid of a poor little ghost.
A little ghost?
Yes. And his present form is not more than 2 feet high.
Blimey! We're Georgie Mendoza!
And after all, what could a ghost 2 feet high do to a big man like you?
Well, he could give me a nasty bite on the kneecap.
Anyway, the ghost only appears once a year, on Friday the 13th.
Oh. What's the date today?
Friday the 13th.
I tipped it. Are you sure this ghost is only a little fellow?
Of course. The poor old ghost. Condemned to roam this lonely place year after year.
Poor little fellow.
He didn't mean any harm.
No, I just bumped off three wives, that's all. Any man's love to do that.
Of course,
I'd have done it myself.
Murray, You've got to get it over. Go on into the castle and look for the treasure.
Miss Mendoza. After what you just told me, look, I can't do it.
You mean you're still afraid the ghost will scare you to death?
No. I'm afraid I'll scare him to death.
Well, we're still after that treasure, but according to Olive Lester, we haven't the ghost of a chance.
I need your love so badly. I love you all so madly. But I don't stand a ghost of a chance with you. I want my arms around you. but other arms surround you. And I don't stand a ghost of a chance with you. If you surrender just for a tender kiss or two, you might discover that I'm the lover that's meant for you, and I'll be true. But what's the good of scheming? I know I'll just be dreaming, for I don't stand a ghost of a chance.
I've just discovered that there's a caretaker here at Dracula Castle.
Ah, goody. I wonder if she's my type.
Could be. By the way, his name is Egbert Bones.
Egbert Bones. My word, he sounds a rattling good sort, doesn't he?
Well, Miss Mendoza has persuaded Moe to look for the buried treasure, but he's still not very happy about the ghost.
Well, I don't blame him, Chiefy Pie. This castle's spooky. I just poked my head inside the door, and do you know what happened?
No, what?
Me rabbit's foot grabbed hold of me hand and started to sing, "I don't want to walk without you, baby."
Yes, and have you heard all the weird music that seems to be floating through the atmosphere? Mm. I wonder where that comes from.
Ah, it's probably Spook Jones and his city slickers.
I wonder where old Sir George hid this money.
Well, I know where I hide mine.
Where?
In me girdle.
I found it! I found it!
You found the fortune?
No, I found out to keep my teeth clean and white. The economical way. Your money buys more toothpaste when you choose Colgate Dental Cream.
Breath is sweet, teeth are bright, when you brush them on a night with Colgate Dental Cream.
Well, come on, Hal. We'll leave Moe to look for the hidden treasure. There's the door of the castle, Moe. In you go.
Very well, but Chief, before I go to the castle, do me one last favor.
What?
Talk me out of it.
Go on, in you go.
Oh dear, oh dear. Oh, dear, oh, dear.
Young man, what are you doing here at this hour?
Strike me lucky, a talking ghost.
I am not a ghost. I am the caretaker of this establishment. The day big Egbert Bones.
Blimey, get up to Egbert, will you? How long have you been caretaker, Egg?
Man and boy, a fortnight.
Egg, have you ever seen a ghost?
Oh, many a time. He and I play poker together.
Blimey! A gruesome twosome. What's a ghost really like, Egg?
One of the most charming apparitions who has ever cut himself a piece of throat. Would you care to see him?
Yes, I wouldn't.
Then praise the Lord and I'll pass the apparition.
Egg, I wish you wouldn't talk about ghosts and apparitions. It makes me nervous.
Nervous, eh?
Yes.
Yeah, you're like my soldier, brother. He was undoubtedly the most nervous man in the rifle corps.
Ooh! Don't say that word!
Oh, very well. Well, we'll talk of more cheerful things.
Yes.
Have you ever seen any good funerals lately?
Look, I'll drop it. I'll drop him like a stone in the moat.
I've just been reading a most interesting book, I have.
What is it called, Egg?
Murder in the Vicarage or The Spectre of the Rector.
Oh, shut up, Egg, will you? Stop talking about ghosts. I've got to go through this house and look for the treasure.
In that case, you'll be needing a skeleton key.
A skeleton?
Yes. You know what a skeleton is, I presume?
Yes, a human being with the meat scraped off. Egg, did you hear what I heard?
It's the ghost of Sir George making his nightly round.
Oh,
just a fugitive from the chain gang. Blimey. What was that, Egg?
Sir George. He must have seen a mouse. I must go and scare it away. He always starts to rouse every time he sees a mouse in the house.
Blimey. Egg, you're not going to go and leave me here alone, are you?
You won't be alone. For long.
True?
True. Oh, yes, indeed. You'll have company.
Who, for instance? For instance, who?
The ghost, of course.
But if I'm in the dark, how will I recognise him?
First, a strange light will appear.
Second, a strange light will disappear.
What sort of a light will disappear? What sort of a light?
Israelite.
And then the ghost of Sir George will march around the room with a head tucked underneath his arm.
Blimey, whose head?
Yours. Good night.
A lovely fellow, Egg. I must buy him a death adder for Christmas. Now, I wonder where that fortune is hidden.
Oh.
Who's there?
It's me, Moe, June. And I'm shivering with fright. Here, hold my hand.
Blimey, yes. It's very cold for June. Isn't it? Listen, love, have you any idea where the treasure is hidden?
I can't understand it. Uncle said he tried to send me a spirit message, giving me directions. Oh, why hasn't he sent that message?
Telegram for Miss Mendoza, telegram for Miss Mendoza.
Thank you, Egbert. Here, Moe, you read the telegram. My hands are shaking too much.
I'm having the same trouble with me teeth.
Quick, read it. What's the message?
All right, just a second. It says, money hidden in treasure chest in attic.
But that can't be from my uncle. Uncle is dead.
It must be from him. Listen to the SP, I mean PS.
Well?
PS. Can't say where I am, but there's a hot time in the old town tonight.
He repeats his serenade, and his heart beats so fortissimo when she stands at her Venetian shade. Chirubin, 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 he waits for her each night beneath her little balcony. Hold her tight, but no, she won't agree. Chirubin, she throws a rose and blows a kiss from up above. Chirubin, 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 they're so in love.
Well, never mind the cherry berry bin. We're looking for the bin with the money in it. I wonder where Moe is now. I wonder where June and Hal are. I wonder if they're all together.
Oh, dear. There's that music again, and it's coming from the attic.
That's where the money is hidden. Oh, the door's squeaking. What does that mean?
It wants oiling.
Listen. What can that be?
Sounds like Hopalong Cassidy.
Listen, is that George the ghost?
No, it's Hal the Lashwood. Thank goodness you're here, our pal.
Oh, Maui, Maui, this is awful. One moment I'm hot, then I'm cold, then I'm hot, and then I'm cold again.
No wonder. You're standing under the flaming shower.
ghost in this house. There's another ghost who thinks he's made of glass.
Bloody, what was that?
The silly thing's broken his ankle.
Look at that owl.
Yes.
A cannonball rolling down the stairs.
No, that's not a cannonball. It's a human skull.
Oh, well, that's all right then. Ooh, a skull. I think I'll be going.
Oh, you can't leave me now.
Julie, you're quite right. I can't leave you.
Why can't you leave her?
She's got all of me braces.
I've got a feeling something terrible's going to happen.
It will if she doesn't let go of me braces.
I wonder where we are.
Look. Here's the attic door here. Oh, excuse me, my mistake. Now, I know where all those skulls are coming from.
Why?
That was the scullery.
What's that thing over there with all the arms?
That's your tree where you hang your hat.
Ooh, what's the other thing over there?
That's the goat tree where you hang your goat.
Louis, what's that over there?
That's the pantry.
Yes, Moe?
Ladies first.
I'm not afraid. Here goes. There's the treasure chest in the middle of the room. How can we open it?
We could batter it down with a big blunt instrument.
That's quite right, Moe. Take a swing at it with your nose.
Yeah, now listen. Don't you do it.
Please, please.
I won't shut up at all. I won't stop it. I won't stop it.
How did you brawl?
Nobody said about it in my nose. I'm not going to put up that.
You stop brawling?
I wish it went very well for you, Jim.
Stop brawling.
I do nothing in the car. I talk if I want to talk and nobody's going to stop me from talking.
How can you brawl at a time like this?
I'll brawl if I want to brawl and nobody's going to stop me from
brawling. Why don't you shut your mouth?
I won't shut my mouth at all.
I hate you.
Here's a hammer and chisel. Now open the chest.
Ooh, success, it's open at last.
Oh, but there's no money there.
Not a solitary zack.
No. Ooh, look, there's a note written on our old parchment.
Let's have a look. Oh, strike me lucky.
What does it say, Louis?
Sorry to disappoint you boys, but I got here first.
Got here first? Who got here first?
Ben Chifley.
Yes.
Your mouth actually tastes cleaner when you use Colgate dental cream. But then, never has there been such a foam as Colgate's. It bubbles and swirls into every corner behind and in between your teeth, safely removing every acid deposit and every food particle. Try one brushing with Colgate dental cream. Taste the cleanness, the freshness, and get the wonderful confidence of long-lasting breath sweetness. And that's the end of this week's Colgate Cavalcade featuring Roy Rene, Hal Lashwood, June Mendoza, and Knox Godfrey. Music is by Jack Carpenter and the Colgate Orchestra with the Lester Sisters. This is Eric Parrant saying goodnight and inviting you to be with us at the same time, same station next week, when once again we'll go Colgate Cavalcading.